Hi, this is Anna Lakshmi, Assistant Professor, Department of Mathematics, Sakti College of Arts and Science for Women, Ottanchathiram. In this video, we will see the processing n jobs through two machines problem. Let's see example. In a factory, there are six jobs to perform, each of which should go through two machines, capital A and B, in the order A, B. The processing time for the jobs are given here. You are required to determine the sequence for performing the jobs that would minimize the total elapsed time. What is the value of T? Here we have the six jobs J1, J2, J3, J4, J5 and J6. We have two machines, capital A and capital B, have corresponding processing times. Now we find the smallest element in the processing time. So the smallest processing time in the given problem is 1 on machine capital A. So perform J1 in the beginning. So the reduced set of processing times becomes, that means J1 is neglected. So remaining J2, J3, J4, J5, J6. Again we find out the minimum processing time in this reduced problem is 2, which corresponds to J4 and J5, both on machine capital B. Since the corresponding processing time of J5 on machine A is larger than the processing time of J4 on machine capital A, J5 will be processed in the last and J4 shall be processed next to last. The updated job sequence is, the first place occurs J1, last place is J5, second last is J4. So the remaining processing times are, that means again we neglect J4 and J5. So remaining we get J2, J3, J6 only. Again we find out the smallest value. Now there is a tie among three jobs for the smallest processing time in this reduced problem. This corresponds to J2 and J6 on machine A and to J3 on machine B. As the corresponding processing time of J6 on machine B is larger than the corresponding processing time of J2 on machine capital B, J6 will be processed next to J1 and J2 should be placed next. The updated job sequences, that means the final sequencing order. So first place J1, second place J6, third place J2, fourth place J3, fifth place J4, last place J5. So this is the optimum sequencing order. So the sequence is optimum 1. So now we find out the total elapsed time. So this form the table. First column job, second one machine A, third one machine B, last one ideal time on capital B. Now we put the sequencing order J1, J6, J2, J3, J4 and J5. Machine A have the two section, time in and time out. Initially we start the time in value 0. J1 processing time in machine A is 1 hour. So 0 plus 1 is equal to 1. J6 start from 1. J6 processing time duration is 3 hour. So 1 plus 3 is equal to 4. So J2 start in time in 4. J2 processing time 3. So 4 plus 3 is equal to 7. As well as J3 start from 7, processing time is 8, so the time out duration is 15 hours. J4 start from 15 and duration is 5 hours, so time out is 20 hours. J5 start from 20 hours, duration is 6 hours, so time out is 26 hours. As well as same concept for machine B. Now machine B start from after the completion of machine A. So the initial time value in J1 is 1 hour. So time in is 1. The time duration is 5 hours. So 1 plus 5 is equal to 6. J6 start from 6. Time duration is 10 hours. So total is 16. J2 start from 16. Duration is 6 hours. So 16 plus 6 is equal to 22 hours. J3 start from 22 and duration is 3 hours. 22 plus 3 is equal to 25 hours. J4 start from 25, duration is 2 hours. So 25 plus 2 is equal to 27 hours. J5 start from 27 hours, duration is 29 hours. So final total elapsed time, the overall duration is 29 hours. So capital T is equal to 29 hours. Now find out the ideal time on capital B. Capital B only rest in 1 hour. So it means the ideal time on capital B is 1. Now we find out ideal time of machine A is. So the final total time 29 hours. Machine B total time is 29 hours. Machine A total time is 26 hours. So 29 minus 26 is equal to 3 hours. So therefore the ideal time of machine A is 3 hours. Ideal time of machine B is 1 hour. Thank you.